I want to start off by asking Nick, obviously you ended us with some amazing cliffhangers and stuff like that. So talk to us a little bit about what we're going to see as soon as we hop into season 3, because I know that's the most important question for people here. They want to know, are they going to get resolution fast?
Well, first off, I want to say hello to everybody and thank you for being here for the show. And from us, from the cast, from the writers, you know, all of whom we really, everything that we read from you guys and we hear from you guys, we really cherish. So thank you all for being here. In terms of what's coming up next year, there is a lot of stuff. You're going to get resolution on a lot of things and irresolution on a lot of things. We start off the season, first episode back is pretty much a direct pickup. We're about a couple of hours after where we left off. So we're going to see what happens when Walter goes up to Tahoe. We're going to see what's been going on with Paige and Tim. We're going to be seeing a lot of stuff. There's a lot coming up next year.
Nice. And I know for one of you, it is your very, at least one of you, it's your very first Comic-Con. Yeah?
Yay! Yay! Long overdue.
I want to hear your first impressions. What has this been like so far?
It's been pretty great. They don't want to let me go onto the floor, but we're going to let them make me. Am I right?
Yeah.
It's been awesome. Our fans are incredible. You guys are so much more beautiful than I am. When I look at myself in the mirror in the morning, it knocks me on my feet, off my feet, onto my behind. Here it says, please be aware that many members of the audience might be 18 years of age or younger. So I will not curse, but shoot, Daddy, I love it.
I love it. Now, I do have a question, though. So Sylvester loves this kind of stuff, but he also is not a big fan of crowds and germs and things like that. What do you think his reaction would be if he got to come to something like this?
Have you ever seen the Jake Gyllenhaal movie Bubble Boy? Probably an apparatus like that would be concocted or created so he could walk through the fans of super fun guy like him, right? Something
yeah.
like that.
I think people would clear the way for you for sure.
Yeah, they'd be a little bit terrified.
I love it. Yeah. I love it. So obviously we mentioned the cliffhangers that season 2 left on. One of them is at central to that is Jaden Happy revealed a big secret. What was your reaction when you first read that script for both you and Eddie when you read that moment, and what has the feedback been like from fans?
My first reaction was yes. Yes, showrunners.
My reaction was, come on! We actually found out about it. We have a Christmas dinner every year, the cast and Nick Wooten and Santora. And because we don't get to hang out that much outside of set because we're always working, and the showrunners spilled the beans to us that was going to happen early on.
We thought it was brilliant, didn't we?
Yeah. And we got the scoop on what's really going on, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who's the real?
I mean, the best thing about that everybody asked, which is like, well, who's she married to? And, I'm not going to tell you. But it's really not who you're expecting. I think everybody whom we've told, who we told exactly who she's married
to. It's really awesome.
You really don't know who she's married to. And it's going to be a lot of fun. So I just say stay tuned.
Well, I know all of us are very excited to figure that out. And obviously the other major romantic relationship we have going on among the group, yes, exactly, Wage, that was left on the cliffhanger as well. So we have you going off to listen to some jazz, which is nice and calm, but I know the audience's hearts were all racing to see if Walter was chasing after, if he makes it there and everything. Talk to us about how you feel like season 2 ended for you, your character.
I think it totally made sense. I've kind of been saying in some of the interviews about what Paige feels about Walter at this point. I think her feelings are always there, but she's sort of had to put them aside because she's accepted that Walter just isn't really capable of loving her the way that maybe, you know, she deserves and the way that he really wants to. So she's kind of, it's like her feelings for him have kind of become a little dormant. They're always there, but she's a child and she has to move on with her life. So that's the way I look at it. And I think season 3, Walter definitely comes to Tahoe and you'll have to watch the 2-hour premiere to see how that goes down. It's definitely going to be an interesting interaction when Walter shows up. It's definitely a shock.
Well, you know, one of the things that I love about this show is that it obviously there's chemistry between, you know, Walter and Paige, but you guys have brought on some amazing, you know, guest stars and people that have come in and kind of thrown a wrench into that. And there are people like you, who doesn't love Scott Porter as Tim? I mean, you know, so.
Anybody?
Right? Your eyes full hearts, can't lose.
Yeah. So talk to me a little bit, Nick, about bringing in these people and kind of what it takes to be cast as somebody that's going to come in and kind of throw a wrench in Wage.
Well, you know, Scott Porter, as last year, had a big tryout period. You know, we sort of brought him in and we sort of wanted to see how he would, you know, how it would fit in our storytelling with our group. Because, you know, he's not of the genius, you know, variety, but he is, you know, he's more of a regular guy. And I thought, you know, we thought as we were putting it together, as we saw him and we saw his interaction with these guys, what a perfect, you know, what a perfect addition he was to the group. And how, because he's got a good heart and he's got great energy, and also how, you know, he would be obviously attractive and attracted to the Paige character. And we always thought, you know, this, we adore everyone who, the Wage is phenomenal. You know, we love it. We love that we've, you know, how much we play with it, and we'll continue to. But, you know, it is, there are two characters there. There's Walter and then there is Paige, and Paige is her own person. And we thought, you know, this is a great way for her to sort of individuate throughout that, beyond that relationship.
Yeah. Ari. You got to have your own romantic storyline that ended, of course, tragically. Talk to us about, obviously the show is really fun, we get the cases of the week and all of that, but this is a storyline that really played out through a lot of the season, and you got to, you know, show different sides of not only your character, but your acting ability. Talk to us about that storyline and what it meant to you to be able to do that.
Well, first of all, thank you. That's really sweet of you to say. I feel very lucky to be playing a character that they carved out like that. We got to see every sort of crevasse of this guy finding his first love and, you know, her dying and then getting shot up into the atmosphere. But...
Standard, that old tale.
I think it's a huge testament to our writers, because our show, on paper, when you talk about it, wouldn't really have something like that in it. You know, you wouldn't deal with MS, you wouldn't deal with heartbreak, you wouldn't deal with, a young man not knowing how to handle his brother and his weird girlfriend, sister dying and the whole situation. So it felt almost Shakespearean, and it was really cool. I loved doing it, is the short answer. And then also that, I mean, the scene with Elias and I right before we shoot the rocket up in space, I think we might have only done it twice, like that night, which never happens on Scorpion, but it was just there, so that was pretty magical too. Felt like magic. That storyline really did feel like magic.
Yeah.
And well, he still wears the ring. He still wears the Band-Aid if you guys are watching. So keep on watching. Still wearing it.
Yeah. And obviously that her death had a big impact on Sylvester. Yeah. Are we going to see that continue to play out in this next season? And how so?
I think so. I mean, I don't know too much about what's happening. I could tell you. Yeah, Nick would
but
know.
But then I'd have to, you know. I think that what we're going to see, you know, in terms of this storyline, we're actually going to take the character some different places as opposed to a new love interest. I think that he is still pining for Megan. I think that is a very deep wound for him, and something that we will play out throughout this season. But we'll see him, we'll see him start to come more out of his shell in another interesting way. He may delve into politics. We'll see. I don't know. You know what? Wouldn't you vote for Sylvester?
I'd vote for Sylvester.
I think so. I certainly would myself.
You know, if politics are involved, does that mean maybe some smooching as well? Because I do miss smooching on television.
Yes.
All right.
The answer is yes.
I'd love to. I'm gonna pose one way or the other in case one comes to mind faster. What's either the most fun kind of stunt or activity you guys have gotten to do in one of the episodes you filmed, or what's the most like fun fact? Because you guys spew out these amazing things that I then take to like dinner parties and say, did you know that if you combine these two, what are the things either that you've learned or gotten to do that you say comes most to the forefront of your mind?
Do we all have to come up with something?
I mean, it's not a class assignment, but I'd love to hear.
The facts and the genius talk can be so thick, and we spend so much time learning so much, and I have a really small brain. So unfortunately, I haven't retained much. And every week there's new stuff. I like when something blows up.
That is fun.
Yeah, and it's really cool because this show, I mean, it is a big show, but I feel like this is like a big deal. They're blowing up that van and we get to like do the thing where we're flying out of it. And so yeah, and it's all a great combination of stuff, but I'm, me personally, I have trouble retaining any of the knowledge that Toby has.
Yeah, I think that the stunts are definitely more of a, if you're going to choose one or the other, I can't remember any of the technical stuff at all.
I can't either.
Thankfully, my character doesn't have to really say it very often either. But when I had to, the explosion, the van that was stuck
tornado
with the water.
Tornado
was really fun. Any stunt I can do, hint, hint, Wooten, I'm happy to do.
There's actually one, I think it was Whiteout, so that's, I don't remember which episode number that was, but when
211.
We were out in Antarctica, right?
Yeah.
So basically, I wouldn't say it was very enjoyable in terms of the way that we shot it, because it's like we're out in the cold, and I'm from Canada, so I know what cold is. And yes, but the thing is, I was sweating in this, like, when
those we were wearing parkas inside all day.
That's how we shot
right.
that.
Did
white styrofoam all around.
We should just clarify for people who didn't know, that whole, all that snow stuff was shot in the soundstage, and our crew did an incredible job. I mean, I think it's one of our most beautiful episodes. Yeah. Keep going.
Oh yeah, that's all I had to say.
And that was just an episode where it just was amazing, the production value and all that went into it. And something that I don't know if you saw on TV 10, 20 years ago, and now, you know, the bar has been raised, and I think Scorpion responds to that so well, that like we have to make this look like a great action movie, because if people don't see it here, they'll see it somewhere else.
And a different action movie every week.
I mean,
that's where this production team is just like, you know, your jaw drops sometimes, because it's like every week we do blow. It's not once a season. I mean, all this stuff is like every week, and you're just like, can we even, I mean, from the writer's room perspective, we really do think up crazy things, and we're like, they're just gonna come in here and like, you know, throw something at us. But they say, okay, we can do this, and you know, I think we can do that, and you're like, wow, and you just step back and like, okay, I guess we're blowing up that battleship, you know?
Yeah, and as an actor, it's fun, because you get to feel like, this week I'm in like an Indiana Jones movie, and this week I feel like I'm climbing Everest, and this week it's a bank heist. It's really fun.
Amazing. Well, do you want to take a quick second and say we are going to get to fan questions, so please do think about those and get in position for those. We will get to those in a little bit. But I actually put out on Twitter that I was hosting this panel, and I got so many questions from people all over the world. Your international fans are as rabid as your American fans. And I have to say, the one question I got the most was, we obviously get little tidbits of our characters' backstories throughout the episodes, but everyone was asking if you're gonna get some sort of origin story episode, or even an origin story for a specific character. Do we have anything like that in the works?
You know what, that's actually something that we have been toying with since season one, and we have a great idea for it. And it's not necessarily something I think we can do this season, because we have so much personal and romantic and, you know, action material obviously to get to this year, but there is one that we really love, that we'd love to see where everybody came from. There's a lot. I mean, we've touched on everybody's sort of backstories very, very, you know, briefly, but there's much more to tell on every one of them. So yes.
Nice. And, you know, speaking of your international fans, they also wanted to know, what exotic locations are we going to see? Can you tease any, like, places that they get to go outside of L.A. this season?
I think we're in Bulgaria. Where else are we?
We were just in Bulgaria yesterday.
Yeah, Bulgaria.
San Pedro.
We came here from Bulgaria.
Long Beach.
Do we get to go down? I asked this before, but do you think we can get to go down under?
I think we'll probably go down. We're going to go to Ireland, I believe.
Ken and Bobby.
We go all over the place. I mean, we really are going to go. We're going all over the place this year.
Our production team, it's amazing that they make Southern California look like the entire planet.
Yeah, Earth. Just Earth. That's it.
Nice. Now, obviously, Robert Patrick is not here today, so I'm going to direct this question to you, Nick. There is a hashtag GetCableWoman, and people want to know, is he going to have a romantic interest anytime soon?
Is he going to have a romantic interest? You know, he may. He may. We have an idea coming up for somebody. Who may cross paths with Robert Patrick in a romantic way. So we do have something in mind. We'll see how it plays out as the season goes on. It's
Who's that?
So we'll see. We're gonna find out.
Now we were talking about how difficult it is to kind of, you know, get all that information in your head. You have to recite those lines of all that scientific jargon. But you guys are grown adults doing that. You guys have a younger actor with you that sometimes can have equally difficult paragraphs to pronounce. And you know, Riley is obviously amazing at what he does. Tell me a little bit about what it's like to work with him. Obviously, you guys are all of similar ages, and then you've got him around.
He's great. He's such a hard worker. He always shows up to set prepared. He's a great energy on the set. And it's weird because he makes us step up our game because, you know, the kid shows up knowing his lines and able to do it. And we're like, well, I should probably do the same.
Well, you never know your lines, Eddie, so.
Exactly.
He's like the master of knowing every word. He's a rock star.
Eddie.
I just want to be better than Riley.
How long does that take you, Eddie? Like if you have a big old paragraph of scientific jargon, like how long would you say you spend digesting that?
Me? It's usually about a baseball game and a half. It's that I've realized that Scorpion has made me smarter about learning things is I can't just do it all at once. So I kind of want to go back to school after this because I feel really good at studying now. And then for all the students out there, I think it's good to like do it a bit, then walk away, then do it some more, then yeah.
How about for the rest of you? Or it looked like you might have had something to say, Kat, too.
So I do the whole script on Sunday night, and then I review the scenes before, like the night before we do the scenes. But I do the whole script once in the sitting. I don't know how long it takes me, maybe like 3 hours. How long is a baseball game? I'm not a sports fan. I'm not a sportsman.
No clock, Ari.
I'm not a sportsman. There's no clock, so I don't know. 70 innings. I don't know. How many goalposts do you hit with the, I don't know. The Braves. It takes me the Braves to learn it. I don't know. I'm sorry.
I haven't timed myself. I should probably do that. That's not very efficient for me to not time myself. But
I think it depends on each episode for me.
And sometimes you can learn it, and then it just won't want to come out of your mouth because the words are so long, and then it's late, and it's a good job, though.
For each of the actors, going into season 3, obviously you've done a little bit already, but I'd love to hear from each of you what you hope to see either revealed or develop with your character, either, you know, emotionally or reveal something from their past.
I want to know who Happy's married to. That might be a good thing to know.
I'm excited to just... What I love about the show is these are people who can stop a nuclear bomb from destroying the world or figure out the most complicated math problems in the world, but they have trouble relating to each other. And now that we are lucky enough to do a season 3, we're being forced to interact more, and all the relationships are getting more and more intimate. I mean, you know, Paige was the new person for a while. So now all these relationships are getting closer, and we're all going to get to interact with each other more and more. Different dynamics of characters, people that you haven't seen work together before are going to be put together, I assume. And I think all the characters and actors are so unique that it's really fun when I get a day where I'm working with Kat, and then another week...
That's your favorite day.
That's my favorite day. And then 2 weeks later, I get to work with Ari for 2 days, and it's just
your personal
really
help.
Fun. We're not doing the same thing every episode at all. I love that.
For me, already in the first 3 episodes, we've gotten, you guys are doing great, the writing team's doing amazing. We've already gotten 4 scripts in, we're just shooting right now, our second episode. But for me, I don't know what to look forward to beyond these first 3 episodes, because I think for Paige, I get to do a lot of really cool things, and I think collectively we can all agree that the 3rd episode is one of our favorite episodes that we've had out of all the seasons, and we haven't shot it yet. Hope it comes out as good as it reads, but it's just gonna be, it's very exciting, and it's very different than what the regular episodes are like. We're very excited. Did you know that?
It's amazing.
It'll actually
it's gonna be amazing.
It'll be our second episode, because the first episode's 2 hours, and then our second air.
Oh, yeah, you're right, it's the second episode. Sorry about that. Yeah, so I'm very excited about it, Paige. There's a lot of fantasy that goes on, so, you know,
it's really cool.
It's really cool.
One word, more fire.
That's
done.
Easy.
Done. He's the only one who gets what he wants.
There you go.
These, I don't know, but yes, more fire.
You guys have a very musical cast, and we've gotten to see that kind of play out sometimes.
Wait, we should do it. Do the, no, don't do it.
flat.
Do oh my gosh.
Do it.
Give me
do it.
No.
I'm not.
I'm staying on it. I'm hitting it.
We have two people in our cast that are musical.
Get in. Don't make me do all the notes.
I feel like I'm a drone. I'm doing well. You taught me once by today.
It's okay, well, you can, Jaden, come on.
Hamilton.
Jaden,
I think we have a new Scorpion theme song right there. I think that's what it is.
He just said, did I do it?
The theme song is just us trying to harmonize?
Yeah, I think exactly that recording. Let's record it. Let's put it out there. I love it. But are we going to, obviously the show gets to have fun and play with that kind of the musical abilities of the cast and kind of song and dance kind of stuff. Are we going to get to see more of that in season 3?
We'll see. You know, we definitely tapped into it in the past, and it's something that is, there's such phenomenal talent. You know, that I think, you know, it's hard for us to ignore it, and I think we really don't want to. So somewhere down the line, we'll be exploiting it properly. I'm not sure when, but we will. I think it would be crazy for us not to.
It's very musical when the cameras aren't rolling. I
yes.
Know that.
Yes, very.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
riffs on riffs.
Oh, Scorpion.
I mean, we could go to audience questions, but I think they would honestly just prefer to listen to you guys sing to us.
We could do that for an hour.
But no, I would love, obviously, they want to hear from you guys. I want to hear from you guys. So we're going to take it to the audience and get some of your quizzes questions. And let's start off right here. Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
You're in a spotlight. Looks great.
Thank you. My name is Melissa. I'm from Orange County. And I wanted to know, where did calling Jaden Rabbit come from?
Me.
But is, like, is there a story behind
no,
it?
No, I just come up with pet names for people. It's true, she's just a little rabbit. It's like, you know, I'll find her eating like little carrot sticks and stuff and celery sticks, and she's always got, and she's also, you know what, especially first season, her favorite thing, do you remember? All she was eating, I was like, Jaden, are you eating like meals?
Because I'm right here. Right here.
Well, she was a rabbit because she'd get those little snack packs, like little gummy bears kind of things, and that's all you'd see her eating. So she just have, she has these really petite little hands, although they're very strong, just like Happy. She just opened these little bags, their little petite fingers, and she was really cute. So she's rabbit.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh my God. Hi, my name is Rhonda. I'm from San Diego. Welcome, Ari, to San Diego. Love you.
Love you too.
My question is, what is the hardest part about playing a genius?
You know, I've had to watch A Beautiful Mind like 20 times, and I still don't get it. I hope that helps. I love your city.
Hi, I'm Jeff from San Diego as well.
What up?
Jaden, as Happy, what's the favorite gadget you've had to make on the show?
So I haven't made anything. We have great designers on the show that create these things, and I ask them, what do I do with this thing? So they tell me, and I action, and I mimic. But no, I think it's just pretty fascinating just in terms of just getting to know that all these tools exist. Obviously, that's not my background. They're all pretty cool in terms of just learning like what they can do, so. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Shai from Indianapolis. Obviously, Scorpion is very loosely based on the life of Walter O'Brien. I was wondering, how loose is this relationship?
Well, at this point, you know, at this point, we've sort of, we've really departed from the true stories that we were told from him during the pilot process. So the, what you're seeing and all of these romantic relationships and all this stuff, generally everything we've done since really very early on in the first season has been writer's room material and stuff that we've come up with. You know, it's occasionally we'll interact with him, but like it's become its own thing at this point. So that's pretty much where we are now. It's a creative endeavor.
Alvin.
Hi.
Oh my gosh.
Hi.
Thanks for the name drop during your show.
Yeah.
My question is, are the writers looking at developing an antagonist group much like Scorpion to fight against Scorpion?
Ooh. Ooh,
that was almost a season one thing, right?
Was it?
Wasn't there almost
a... Yeah, you know, we've considered that in the past, and it's a great idea, and there's a lot of fun to it, but we carry very, very little over in terms of episode to episode, in terms of like the A story stuff. So that would require an arc that we have not yet done. Most of the stuff that obviously carries over is personal stories. So that's something that would require us really taking on, you know, a lot of episodes to develop, because you have to get to know them and you have to fight them and you have to lose and you have to win. So it's definitely something that has come up in terms of when or how we do it is sort of up in the air. But it's a great idea. I mean, there's a great sort of alter ego to these guys out there somewhere. So someday.
Hi, my name's Nora. I'm from Virginia. Hey. Question for Jaden. First of all, Jaden, thank you very much for showing a strong Asian woman on television. And my question is, do you find that there are specific challenges because you're Asian to find work as an Asian actress, or has it gotten better over the years?
I think for me, I can only speak from my own individual experience, and I think that as actors, there's always something that might keep us from getting into a room. You know, whether it's ethnicity, your height, the way you look, all of that. So in terms of like my ethnicity, perhaps, I'm not sure. I try not to really focus on that. I think what I'm seeing these days is like there's diversity and the progress is amazing, and I'm very grateful to be on this show, and regardless of the color of my skin, and have happy not be defined by the color of her skin. So, yeah, there's that.
Kat, did you have something to add?
I just saw
you lean forward. I wanted to give you the opportunity.
Yeah, well, I was just gonna make a compliment to Jaden that I think she is, I mean, one of the best actresses around on television. Everything she does on our show is so believable. And so, I don't know why I was just gonna, that's what I was gonna say.
That's all love.
Thanks, Kat.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm Remy from Chicago.
Hey, Remy. Hello. Chicago.
I was just wondering if you guys do any pre-episode rituals before you start filming?
No.
Do you guys?
It just all happens so fast.
Yeah. Yeah.
A lot of time. I mean, these episodes are a lot of work to shoot, and they bleed over. Sometimes we're doing two in a day. Sometimes you're like, which episode are we working on? And it's.
Sometimes I have a donut on Fridays from Crafty. It feels really good.
Eddie and I get sushi once a year.
I used to take a lunchtime nap, but it made me even more grumpy.
Yeah, he would talk
so
about that a lot.
Doing that.
Man,
but I might bring it back because I like naps.
See, season one, like halfway through season one, remember he was like, you know, you guys, I think I discovered I've got to stop taking naps during lunch break because I've not taken a nap today. I'm not as grumpy.
Grumpiness is the big contest on set. Who's going to be grumpy today? And I don't want to be the grumpy guy.
Hi.
We have time for one more question.
Hi, my name is Erin. I'm from San Diego.
And hey, Erin.
I just wanted to know, when you guys use a technology like the drones, him trying to upload Megan's mind, even the cloning, are you looking at research happening now, or are you just making it up?
We're always looking at research that's happening now. You know, we're looking at, it can be very sort of futurist oriented. It can be stuff that is just theoretical. But we really do kind of look to those things. You know, we look to see what's happening all around the world and who's sort of in the cutting edge. But again, things that are happening, but things that could possibly happen. And that's really, we draw it from every resource in that regard. And then we sometimes, you know, and if we come to something that we're just, you know, we'll find somebody who's an expert in that field and we'll bring them in and we'll interview the hell out of them and say, and then we'll build a story around that. So that's how we do it.
Well, I want to thank all of you guys for being out here in the audience. And of course, let's give a round of applause to our cast and executive producer right here.